Hello everyone, welcome to Talent Battle. This video is related to our campaign Ask Your Doubt and Get a Video Solution. In this video, we will be solving questions asked by some students from various parts of our country. If you are also having any doubt or question related to aptitude, you can check a Google form link in the description of this video and you can ask your doubts over there. But before that, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video, as we will be posting all the videos on our YouTube channel. So let's start with the question. This particular question was asked by Pritesh from AMC College of Engineering. Let's check the question. A trader gives 12% additional discount on the discounted price. After giving an initial discount of 20% on labeled price of an item, the final sale price of the item is 704. Find out the labeled price. Now, one thing you need to understand to solve this question. Suppose if we consider that labeled price over here, whenever we are going to give discount on that particular price, we are going to get a selling price. Okay, whenever we give, suppose if you visit to any store and there is any item or thing and whatever labeled price is over there, whenever they provide discount on that, you are going to get, or they are going to provide you at that particular price. So it will be a selling price. Now in this case, what has happened? There have been two discounts, check. A trader gives 12% additional discount on the discounted price after giving initial discount of 20%. So suppose I will consider the label price as 100x. Then 20% of the discount. How can we give 20% of the discount? 20% of the discount is called as 80 by 100. Okay, the normal formula for selling price is CP into 100 minus loss percentage divided by 100. Loss percentage is nothing but like discount percentage. Okay, right now I am not clearing all the basics. I am directly checking the question. So how we can give discount of 20% on that value? That value into 100 minus 20% by 100. Again, the additional 12% discount has been given. Now how can we give 12% discount on this value? Into 88 by 100, like 100 minus 12 by 100, which is 88 by 100. And then I will get the selling price. In this case, the selling price they have given as 704 rupees. So just calculate x. It will be 704 into 100 into 100 divided by 80 into 88. So if you calculate 20 into 4, 20 into 5, 4 into 1, 4 into 25. So if you try to calculate the relation between this, 88 into 8 is 704. If you calculate this, 8 into 5 is 40. 40 into 25 is nothing but 25 into 4, 100 means 1000. So the label price was initially 1000 rupees. Then he gave discount of 20% and then again a discount of 12% on that. And then he sold that particular item at 704 rupees. So whenever you are going to face such questions, take value of labeled price as X. Whatever discount they have given, just 100 minus that discount divided by 100. Now in this case, two discounts were there, is equal to selling price. So the answer in this case is rupees 1000. This particular question was asked by Ritika from College of Engineering and Management, Kolaghat. Just check the question. On Republic Day, sweets were equally distributed among 450 children. But on that particular day, 150 children remained absent. Thus, each child got 3 sweets additionally. How many sweets did each child get? So ultimately, we need to calculate how many sweets that each children or child is getting. So what we can do? First, we can consider total number of sweets as x. Suppose I am having total number of sweets as x. As you know, on the Republic Day, it was planned to have around 450 children, but on that day 150 children remained absent. So each child got 3 sweets extra. So I need to create some equation. What equation I can create? I can say to 300 children, whatever the sweets they got, minus 450 children sweets, okay, which was supposed to initially distribute, is equal to 3. Now suppose I need to write down the total number of sweets were x, and if I want to distribute it among the 300 students or childrens, how I can distribute it? X divided by 300. So each child will get x divided by 300 sweets, minus how I could have distributed it among 450 children. Total number of sweets are x divided by 450 is equal to 3. So this equation is important. The sweets which students actually received on that day, which is x divided by 300, minus sweets which were initially supposed to distribute, like x divided by 450, is equal to 3. So just calculate 450x minus 300x, this is 150x, divided by 300 into 450 is equal to 3. So 150 into 2, so value of x will be 3 into 2, 6, 6 into 450. 450 into 6 is nothing but 2700. So total number of sweets I can say is 2700. But that is not the question which they have asked. What they have asked, how many sweets did each child get? As you can check, on that particular day, 150 children remained absent. So total 450 children, out of that 150 remain absent means we are discussing about 300 children. So each child will get total sweets 2700 divided by 300. So each child will get 9 sweets on that particular day. So the answer for this question will be 9. This particular question was asked by Shubham from DKT College, Isalkaranji. The question is, P plus Q means P is the brother of Q. P minus Q is P is mother of Q. P star Q means P is the sister of Q. Then which of the following means M is maternal uncle of R? So this question belongs to blood relation topic. So for which you can draw the diagram and you can solve the question. Now we need to go option by option. M plus K plus R is the first option. So try to draw a diagram. As plus sign means brother, so M is brother. Now whenever you are solving blood relation question, you can use the notation like, whenever the person is male, you can draw a rectangle. So M is brother of K, K is brother of R. But it does not mean M is the maternal uncle of R, because in this case they will be brothers. So first option is incorrect. Check the second option, M minus R plus K. Now what is the meaning of minus? P minus Q means P is mother of Q. So in this case M is mother of R. Okay, since she is mother, I have drawn a circle. So you can draw a circle for female. Okay, to just the simple notations, general notations. Next, plus K means R is the brother of K. So R is the brother of K. So what they have asked, M should be the maternal uncle of R. As you can check, M is anyhow female, so she cannot be a maternal uncle. So that is not the correct answer. Check the next option, M plus K minus R. Plus means brother, so M is the brother of K. Minus R means, so minus sign denotes to mother, so K is the mother of R. Now check the relation between M and R. R's mother is K, K's brother is M. So mother's brother, you can say uncle or maternal uncle. So M is maternal uncle of R, which is the correct answer. So to solve these type of questions, just you need to draw the diagrams using notations. Then it will be very easy for you to get the answer. This question is asked by Abhishek from Anurag Group of Institution. Let's check the question. A sum of money becomes 7 by 5 of itself in 4 years at certain rate of simple interest. The rate per annum is. Now, the formula for simple interest, as we know, it is TRT by 100, principal, rate of interest and time. Now, whenever you are going to face these type of questions where they will say 2 times, 3 times or like 7 by 5 times of that particular amount, to make it easy, consider the principal as 100 rupees. Okay, so I will just put the values over here. Principal is 100, rate I want to calculate, time they have given as 4 divided by 100. Now, what will be the simple interest? Simple interest is nothing but whatever that amount is, like suppose 100, and it is becoming 7 by 5 of itself. So 100 into 7 by 5. So what is the amount after 4 years? 5 into 20, the amount is going to be 140 rupees. But what is the simple interest? The simple interest formula is nothing but amount minus principal. So amount after 4 years is 140. Principal is 100 rupees. So actual simple interest is nothing but 40. So I can write simple interest as 40. 100 and 100 will get cancelled. Rate of interest will be 10%. So answer for this question is B, 10%. So just make sure whenever they will give you questions like 2 times of itself, 3 times or like 7 by 5 times, consider principal as 100, calculate the amount, then calculate the simple interest. Just put the values and then you will get the answer. If you like this video, click on the like button. For any doubts, suggestions or feedback, please comment on this video and subscribe to our channel to stay tuned to various placement updates. Press the bell icon for notifications. Thank you.